In this video, I'm going to be showing you an excellent piece of software by KG5RKI, which allows you to update the MD-380 and MD-390 firmware to the latest TYT MD-380 tools firmware and apply the user database very quickly and easily. If you hadn't heard of these things already, let me give you a very quick explanation. MD-380 Tools is a project to improve the MD-380 and MD-390 radios by adding features in new firmwares that you can download and apply to your radio at home. TYT MD-380 Tools is a branch off the main MD-380 Tools project that has a few additions. You'll see the term flash used in this video and in the software. In this context, the term effectively means to write the firmware onto the radio. The UserDB is a database of amateur radio operators who use DMR. Putting this file on your radio allows the radio, once modified with the firmware, to show information about who is talking by looking up their DMR ID in the database. The software we're looking at today allows you to apply the latest firmware and user database to your radio with very little effort. So, let's get started. The first thing you need to do is download the software. I'll leave a link to this in the description. Then open it up and extract the files. Double-click the .exe to run the software. So, let's update the firmware first. There are different firmwares depending on which radio you have. So if you have a non-GPS radio, then click Download Non-GPS, and if you have a radio with GPS, then click on Download GPS. In my case, I'm going to click on Download Non-GPS because my radio doesn't have GPS. It's important to select the correct option here because if you flash the wrong firmware to your device, then it could cause it to stop working. Once the appropriate firmware has finished downloading, you need to prepare your radio by putting it into DFU mode. To do this, hold down the upper function button and push the push-to-talk button while turning the radio on. The LED should start flashing red and green. Then you can connect the radio to your computer and click flash to apply the firmware update. Wait for the progress bar to finish twice and it should be completed. At this point, you can turn your radio off and back on again, and it will now have the latest firmware. To update the user database, simply click Download Update, and then once it has finished downloading, click Flash. The radio does not need to be in DFU mode for this. It can just be turned on normally. You now have the latest user database in your radio. When you talk to someone who is in the database, their information should come up on the screen of your radio, as will be demonstrated in this video clip.
3, go ahead.
Let's see, 113. Have you got your code plug, over?
I didn't, Lee. I haven't got that in. Sorry about that. I'm sorry, I thought you said 13. No, I haven't got 800.
Let's see, I'm top group 80, G4S, DM portable.
So, thanks for watching. Consider subscribing if you haven't already, and please hit that like button if you enjoyed this video.